Okay, hello everyone. Today we are starting with the Gaussian numericals from the Gauss theorem. We are starting with the exercise. Let us start with the first question. In the first question, he is saying you a point charge of 1.8 microcoulomb is at the center of the cubical Gaussian surface of 55 centimeter side. Find the net electric flux through the surface. So what we have to do, we have to find out the value of phi. So for finding the value of phi, we know by the Gauss theorem, we are having the formula okay, phi equals to q upon epsilon 0. So let us see this question. So we know that phi equals to q upon epsilon 0. So what we have to do, we have to find out the value of, we have to find out the value of net electric flux. So q is given to us. How much is the q? The value of q is 1.8. It is in microcoulomb. So microcoulomb can be converted into coulomb by multiplying it with 10 to the power 6. So we have converted into coulomb, and the value of epsilon 0 is 8.85 into 10 key power minus 12. So on solving it we are getting 0.2 0.203 into 10 key power 6 we are getting. So on shifting the point, so it will be 2 into 10 key power 4. So what will be the what about the unit? The unit will be Newton. The unit will be Newton meter square per coulomb square. So this is your question number 1. Now starting with the second question. The second question is the net outward flux through the surface of a box is itna. What is the net charge inside the box? So again we have to find the net charge. Again the same formula we have to use. So we have phi equals to q upon epsilon 0, and the value of phi is given to us. The value of phi is 8 into 10 key power 3 equals to q upon epsilon 0. So q will be equals to 8 into 10 key power 3 into, putting the value of this phi, the value of this phi is 8.85 into 10 key power minus 12. So on solving this we are getting 70 into 10 key power 9. So on solving this, our answer will be 70.8 micro coulomb. So this is the answer for question number 2. Now coming to question number 3, a point charge produce an electric flux of minus 750 Newton meter square per coulomb square through the spherical Gaussian surface of 10 centimeter radius with the center at the charge. First, if the radius of the Gaussian surface be double, how much flux would pass through the surface and what is the magnitude of the charge? So the first part is very easy. He's simply asking you the charge. Radius is double, we are doubling the radius, and he is asking you how much flux. So flux is unaffected by the radius, so the flux will be same, minus 750 Newton meter square. Okay, because it is unaffected, because by the Gauss theorem the formula is phi equals to q upon epsilon 0. It is unaffected by r, so radius does not affect, so it will be same, minus 750 Newton meter square per coulomb square. For the second part, what is the magnitude of the point charge? So for this part, what we have to do, we have to again use the formula, that is phi equals to q upon epsilon 0. By putting the value, solving it, we will get the answer. So do it yourself. Coming to question number 4. An isolated conductor of any shape has a net charge of 10 microcoulomb inside the conductor is the cavity within which is the point charge of plus 3 microcoulomb. What is the charge on the cavity wall? So charge on the cavity wall will be 3 microcoulomb. Okay, and on the outer surface of the conductor, so for the outer surface, this 3 coulomb and that this 10 coulomb will be added up. So on the outer surface, it will be 13 microcoulomb. Now coming to question number 5, question number 5 is important. It is of 2006. An infinite line charge produces an electric field of 9 into 10 to the power 4 newton coulomb. The electric field is given to us at a distance of 2 cm, what is the linear charge density? He is asking you to calculate the linear charge density. Now, let us do this question. So, the intensity of the electric field is given to us. It is E equals to 9 into 10 to the power 4 Newton per coulomb, and R is given to us, it is 2 cm. This 2 cm can be converted into meter, so that means 2 into 10 to the power minus 2. Then he is asking you the value of lambda, he is asking you the value of rho, the surface charge density. So surface, we know the formula, okay, that E equals to how much? It will be equals to, E will be equals to 2 rho upon 2 pi epsilon r. So this is the value of E. So the intensity is given to us, it is 9 into 10 to the power 4. We have to calculate the value of this rho. So rho equals to E into 2 pi epsilon 0 r. All the values are given to us, so let us put the values. So first of all it is 2 pi epsilon 0. Let us do one thing, multiply it with 2 and divide it by 2, so that it's become 4 pi epsilon 0. So E 4 pi epsilon 0 and upon 2. So now let us put the values, and r is also there. So the value of E will be 9 into 10 to the power 4, and the value of radius will be how much? The value of radius will be 2 into 10 to the power minus 2, and upon 4 pi epsilon 0, the value of this is 9 into 10 to the power 9. We have put it the values. Now on solving this, we get 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb per meter. So this is your linear surface charge density. So today this much. Some more questions are there, so we will do it later on, or you will try it by yourself. In the next video, we will start with the next chapter, that is electric potential. Thank you very much.